One of the most familiar images associated with forensic science is that of an investigator dusting for prints. But do you really only just need a brush and black powder? Forensics case number 8, dusting for prints. You've seen it 100 times. The TV CSI team rolls up to a crime scene, and there's usually a throwaway line right off the bat about dusting for prints. It's the kind of scenario that leads viewers to believe that dusting with black powder is the only way to go when it comes to uncovering fingerprint evidence. That isn't always the case here in the real world. Variables such as the environment and the type of surface factor greatly in the technique chosen by the investigator to find prints. The standard dusting technique, like the one you see on TV, is typically used on non-porous surfaces like glass, marble, metal, or plastic. The powder adheres to the residue deposited by a finger, revealing a print. Since crime scenes are made up of more than just non-porous surfaces, there are other powders in the investigator's arsenal. Magnetic powder is sometimes used to avoid smudging, while color powders can allow for better visibility. Some are even fluorescent. And when powder isn't the best tool for the job, investigators turn to light, heat, and gas to discover the print. Alternate light sources can show prints on doorknobs, bottles, and railings. These laser or LED lights emit a particular wavelength or spectrum of light that illuminates the evidence. Some have filters to photograph difficult-to-see prints. And for surfaces like metal, glass, and plastic, superglue fuming can be used. Yeah, that's superglue. In a lab, an analyst heats up the superglue, or cyanoacrylate, in a fuming hood. The heat causes the glue to release gases that stick to the oily residue of a print, allowing the investigator to see it. This same science can be done at a crime scene using a portable wand. It's a tricky technique, and investigators have to be careful not to distort the print by fuming it for too long. And it gets even trickier when developing prints on porous surfaces like fabric or unfinished wood. One technique, iodine fuming, is done in a fuming chamber by heating up iodine crystals that, like superglue, produce a gas that adheres to the oils left by print. The print fades pretty quickly, so unless it's sprayed with a starch or water solution, you better get a quick picture. Now, I could talk about this all day, but these are just a few of the many techniques that are at an investigator's disposal when looking for prints. So when your favorite program makes it seem like all you need is powder and a brush to find a print, it's definitely forensics, and it should be left in the dust.